What's happening, Munchos? My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
And what are we doing today, Bhatia?
We're doing some Vroom Vroom. We're doing Ford versus Ferrari.
Yes.
Matt Damon, Christian Bale.
Absolutely. Welcome back to Good, Bad & Filmy, guys. And yeah. We've got our in-house motor expert with us, Shreyas.
Yo.
So what's happening here?
So basically, if you guys don't know, you guys ought to know, Le Mans, or which is spelled L-E-M-A-N-S, is a famous it's a famous track in France. France is very big when it comes to motorsport. The International Federation of Automobiles, which basically controls Formula 1, MotoGP, etc., is headquartered in France. So basically, this track is steeped in history for supercar manufacturers or any car manufacturer to win. This was a huge deal to make a statement.
It's been one of the most prestigious races in world racing history.
Correct.
And this movie, here we take upon how Ford took on Ferrari.
Yes.
And Ferrari being the giant that they were back in the day, and they still are obviously in the overall motorsport industry.
Yes.
So this is Ford taking over Ferrari and the history between it, and the story of two guys particularly, Ken Miles and Cal Shelby. James Mangold back in the director seat, and what a blast, man. I had a lot of fun with this movie. There's so much to talk about here.
I will divide it, but why don't we start with the goods first?
Let's get on the goods.
Okay.
So first and foremost, I want to talk about James Mangold, man. I think the guy does not get enough credit. He's done amazing movies, right? He's done, he's in Logan, he's in Walk the Line, he's done some really good movies. He's done Identity, which I really liked as a thriller.
Oh, he did Identity?
He did Identity, he was the director. And this now, so this is one director that, I think does not get enough acclaim. Because he doesn't do too many commercial, big, blockbustery movies.
Okay.
But every movie he does has a lot of heart. He has a lot of, good filmmaking behind it.
I'd say so, definitely counting the movies that you just spoke about. However, I think the chink in his armor is that Wolverine Japan movie.
I actually really enjoyed Wolverine until the last third of the last third act.
So something was off.
But Logan redeemed, everything that he did wrong there.
Absolutely.
Done with Logan.
Right, so, but would you count this movie as, on par with those movies that you just
would. For us racing, I'm a complete layman when it comes to motor racing and everything. So I don't really have all the knowledge about the history and all of that.
Yeah.
And if a guy like me is dropped into a movie that's very heavy on the, the history, the people who were famous, the legends and all that.
Right.
There are times that I miss out on this.
Correct.
And in this movie, at no point was I ever lost.
That's
which I think is a very big positive for the movie.
Totally.
Any layman can just grab or can be dropped into this movie. They understand what the world is, who the main characters are, what drives them, what their passions are, and how they're going, taking on these corporate monsters who are trying to, kind of embellish their dreams and all that.
Right.
But they're still being driven by their passion, which is racing and motorsports.
Right.
And I had a lot of fun with it as a layman.
Fair, I think that's actually a good point, because the whole concept of motorsport is that it's very niche, and to be able to follow it, you have to actually follow it for years and years to actually get an understanding of it. So the fact that someone who's not from that interest area to enjoy this movie, I think kudos to the director that way. Specific things that I liked, slight disclaimer, don't hate me. I'm not a big fan of Matt Damon, I'm sorry.
Who are you again?
I liked him in The Martian, that's about it.
He's not seen The Bourne Identity, I don't know what's
I've seen. No, I've seen it, but I just don't like it. I'm not bothered about it. And when he plays, quote unquote, dick in Interstellar, I was perfect role. That's how I see him. In this movie, he's playing the role of Carroll Shelby.
Absolutely. And he nails it.
Yeah, he's insane. So, Carroll Shelby is this legendary car designer. And basically, he was a former racer himself. He's the one who won Le Mans. He's the only American to have won Le Mans before Ford entered with their GT40s. And he actually had to give up racing because he had a heart condition, which they show in the movie. He keeps on popping these pills. Matt Damon doing his thing, showing that passion of his own team, setting up his own company, partnering with Ford, sort of having that love-hate sort of thing with Ken Miles, who's played by Christian Bale. So these two guys specifically, they were spot on.
And how can we forget Christian Bale? We saw him put on so much weight for Vice once again.
Right.
And we saw him super lead, almost like the Machinist.
Yes.
Again, once again, for this movie.
Yes.
This guy, Christian Bale, is a method actor, like none other in Hollywood at the moment.
Yeah.
He goes all out for any role that he, you know, takes on.
Yeah.
And even here, the mannerisms, the way he talks, he seems like such a country guy.
Yes.
He's such a loose cannon in this movie that you just enjoy watching him, and that the chemistry between them two, they have their, you know, fights and they have their arguments as well, but you know, both of them love each other, both of them have massive respect for each other, and it's just such a blast to watch them share the screen together.
Absolutely, man, I agree. It's you know, they're very different actors, they're very different roles, and just the way it comes together every now and then, there's friction here and there, there's respect, there's, you know, a lot of going back and forth, but it's just held together so well from start to finish.
Right.
So, James Mangold, smart decision getting these two guys to do.
Another thing that I really liked was this movie, though it is based on motorsport history, it's not a complete racing movie. If you go into this movie thinking you're just going to get races, you're setting yourself up for failure.
Right.
This is more a personal story about these two guys and their, you know, how they made history together.
Correct.
And obviously their racing is a very big part of it.
Yes.
But it's their journey of how they get there.
Correct.
And the final race is nail-biting. I was on the edge of my seat as a layman. I really, really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Especially the way Mangold has shot the racing scenes. Even as a guy who's not a big racing fan, it's just so much fun to watch.
Yeah, totally, man. So yeah, so if he had a good time, imagine what I was going through. But not only just the racing, the way it's shown, like, I have a personal connect with this particular car that they're talking about, that this show.
GT40,
and I've been lucky enough to see it on the streets of Delhi, I don't know how. And I've always kept a note about this car. It doesn't look like a car that's made from America. It looks very close to your Italian supercars. It sounds, you know, pure muscle. It's very, very obnoxious, very loud and brutal. And I think they've captured that essence very well in the movie.
Right.
Every time Carroll Shelby is, even in his one of his small cars, which is the AC Cobra, the Shelby Cobra, that car is loud.
Yeah.
It's so freaking loud. And the way they've shot it, you know, the overtaking scenes, the close-ups, and the fact that, you know, these races that they're talking about were in the mid-60s. But just the way the camera angles are shot, the, you know, panning in and out, just, I was admiring that car left, right and center.
Absolutely.
So, maybe I wasn't a fan of James Mangold until yet, or I was a hidden fan.
Yeah.
Now I'm very obviously a fan.
On
this
board,
was some,
absolutely. And I really know the team behind the scenes working with Shelby's team.
Pops.
Yeah, exactly. And these are nice characters, you know, have around, they bring a nice dynamic to the entire team, so it's fun to watch.
Right.
But I think you have some bad stuff as well, so. Let's get to the bad.
Okay. More hating coming your way, bear with me please. So, I mean, they're trying to show, so this is basically post-Second World War, we're about 20 years post the Second World War. But people are still sort of riling off from that, you know, the US is killing it, they're showing up everywhere. So it's almost like Ford is trying to be overbearing, and they're trying to stake their claim. And Ford being Ford is sort of, you know, holding the American flag high, and the Europeans have like this totally different culture, and they realize that, you know, Americans don't cut it, and they're just showing off here. So I get that you're trying to show that, you're trying to show that corporate, you know, snobism, you're trying to show, you know, pure hard passion against these, you know, these suited, booted guys.
Right, exactly.
However, I think it's a little too obvious for me. I think, you know, it's so exaggerated, it's so in your face, like, it couldn't have been like that. Like, we know that the Italians have a certain way of talking and doing things, and I don't know, I mean, it's a light movie, it's nothing to be like, it's not a plot point, so. But just because I know more about these guys and I know how things go, you know, in the pits, in the paddock, it was just a little, I don't know, I could see through
it. For you?
I don't know. But yeah, I don't mind.
As a layman, I actually didn't mind all of that, because I think it helped me kind of like grasp onto whatever was happening there. Because if you just drop into a lot of technical stuff, then I think for any person who's not a big fan, who doesn't understand, you know, motorsports inside out, for them it becomes a little harder to latch onto, you know, grasp of what's happening.
Right.
But I completely understand what you're talking about. And also I read, so I was really, you know, I got really excited watching this movie.
Yeah.
So I went up home and read up about it.
Right.
And I realized that they kind of shuffled things around and did the history in the movie a little bit.
Again,
just to make it a little more dramatic and, you know,
purposes,
exactly.
Right.
So I'm okay with it. I'm asking.
Doesn't change anything,
right? But they've kind of like shuffled around the events a little here and there.
Yes.
But that's fine.
That's fine. Yeah. And I mean, the fact that it's not a racing movie and they want to show a lot of personal stuff, I think. You know, like, also, so this racer Ken Miles, he basically has a family. He's, you know, way past his supposed career. Like, he has this one last chance, you know,
he's
make
in his
history.
40s,
correct.
He's not
kid.
Dreaming of
yeah,
anymore.
Right. So, just, I think that family angle, I was sort of wanting more.
Right.
Just to see that he has a family and that they're counting on him, but they have, like, these usual struggles of, you know, putting food on the table, thinking about, you
right.
know, where your career's going and family aspirations and stuff. So, I don't know, it was fitted there to show that he's a family man. He's not like this professional racer at the top of his game.
Right.
It's just that he's doing this because he has a relationship with Shelby, with Karen Shelby.
And apparently he's passionate about it. Like, he
yeah.
wants to do it.
Right. And yeah, and literally, like, he's sitting in the cars and he's like, oh, this is wrong. And he talks to the car. So that's great. I got that personality of him, but I didn't
like,
get the family bit of him
I
too
understand,
much.
I understand.
So yeah, maybe it's not the best shot in terms of like cohesion,
right.
but overall I think it's a good package.
Absolutely. Let's deep dive into this and
yes.
get into the film now.
Okay, finally filming. There were some scenes which were so freaking cool. I found myself actually like clapping.
Yeah.
And more often than not, I was the only one because I was like, ha ha ha, I get that. And they're like, there's not much going on.
Yeah.
But no, it was really cool. And I think there was one particular scene which is captured so well in terms of showing like the American side. You know, this corporate guy, so this is basically Henry Ford II, the
right.
son of the founder of Ford, Henry Ford. And basically, Karen Shelby invites him to check out the car that they've designed to perform at Le Mans. And it's a sports car, it's a small car, it's
right.
a very low car. This guy's your typical stout, you know, fat guy.
Yeah, yeah.
And Shelby's like, why don't we take her for a spin? And he's like, we don't usually do that. He's like, it's your car, so let's do this. And he puts him in the car and he blows his
yeah.
mind. And this guy has such a extreme personal reaction
right.
and you don't know where it's coming from. It is such a long drawn out reaction. I burst out laughing. I was
I,
like,
I think everybody burst out laughing.
Yeah,
right?
it
was a great scene.
Yeah, it was so nice to see. So that now if you want to show Americans being American, show me that.
Yeah.
Don't show me
that's
the
true.
The rest of the stuff. So yeah, so that particular scene was insane, and obviously that adds into, you know, the sounds of the cars, the way they've shown the cars, etc, etc.
Also, I think the movie does a really good job of establishing the, you know, rivalry between Ferrari and Ford.
Yes.
Even though the movie is more about two guys,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
who are
yeah.
Ken Miles
but
and, you
the
know,
insults.
Shelby. Yeah, but the insults and the back and forth between
yeah,
them,
yeah,
these two
yeah.
powerhouses in the
right.
motorsport industry,
right.
and how one team is trying to take over the other,
yes.
and you, the back and forth there, I think the movie does a really good job of setting it up.
Right.
Even though it might not be the most accurate depiction,
yes.
but for a layman, it's just entertaining to see, oh, these guys, big guys, Enzo Ferrari,
yes.
before the second,
yes,
and these
yes.
guys, they were at it like
yeah,
this.
Pretty much.
So just the depiction there was a relief,
yeah.
for me it was a lot
yeah.
of fun to see.
Right, I mean, I'd agree there, and this is also a little bit of fact that Ferrari is not only responsible for creating Ford's racing team and the Ford GT40, Ferrari is also responsible for Lamborghini, because Lamborghini used to make tractors, and he was a very rich guy, and he used to buy Ferraris, and he went up to Enzo Ferrari, and he said, oh, can you make your cars like this, like that? And Enzo said, bro, you make tractors, you make the tractors, I'll make the supercars. He got offended.
Are we getting a sequel to this movie?
And the rest is history, and we have Lamborghini right now. So Enzo Ferrari, thank you very much for insulting a lot of people. We now have more racing teams and car manufacturers.
Absolutely.
Thanks to you. So yeah, they've shown that Italian sort of masala, their little bit, their mannerisms and
yeah.
their sort of snobbishness, which they sort of almost earned because their cars are so beautiful.
Right.
So that was also a nice thing to see.
So all in all, I think this kind of wraps up our review. I overall had like a lot of fun with this movie.
Yes.
For a layman and
yes.
someone who does not have a lot of knowledge about the motorsports,
right.
being dropped into something like this,
right.
I was pleasantly surprised.
Right.
I had a lot of fun and I definitely recommend it to all the people watching this video.
Awesome. So let's do ratings.
Absolutely. Let's get down to it.
Cool. So ratings wise, I think, okay, the actors, you latch onto them 100%.
Right.
The cars for me, beautiful.
100%.
Right, so, and the fact that I was clapping, like laughing out loud, I'd give this definitely like 2 thumbs up. And I'd watch it again just to see Matt Damon doing his thing, just to see the cars like that. And to, you know, see Henry Ford freak out in his own freaking racing car.
Absolutely, I can't put it any better. I think that the directing here is top notch.
Yep.
The racing scenes are exciting, they're
yes.
thrilling.
Yep.
You can feel the adrenaline, you know, in your body when the cars are going up against
yes,
each other.
Yes.
The chemistry between Ken Miles and, you know, Karen Shelby is done really,
yeah.
really well.
Yeah.
You latch onto their brotherhood,
yes.
camaraderie of sorts.
Yes, yes.
And even the team supporting team is really good.
Yeah.
All in all, I had a lot of fun with this movie, so
yeah.
I'll definitely give this 2 thumbs up.
Nice.
Do check it out for sure.
Yeah. I just wish it wasn't called Ford vs Ferrari. I mean,
should have been just been Miles and Shelby.
Oh yeah.
Better than
so whoever the production house was, tap us up, we'll work for free.
Yeah, absolutely. Not
right.
work, we don't work for free.
Okay.
What did the joke say? If you got something, never do for free.
Right.
Yeah. Alright, so yeah, I guess that wraps up our review. Do let us know in the comments below what you guys think of the movie.
Right.
If you liked it, if you didn't like it, if there are some things that we've kind of not understood or not spoken about, do let us know in the comments below.
Yes, please.
And yeah, as usual, like, share, subscribe, guys.
Awesome.
Be back for more. Cheers.